Subscribe for my channel Amol Ujagre and hit the bell icon for latest update.
Hey, hi. One question I always come across that you guys are working on programming, you guys are working on your automation scripts. The scripts probably looks very fine, but when you will run that, so it behaves quite in a weird way. So you have issues, you have errors, you have exceptions. Many times people has a habit that they immediately run to their friends, their colleagues, or their teachers or trainers, because they are scared of these issues. They are scared of the exceptions. They are scared of the errors in the program. And I've been asked this question so many times that how to learn to resolve the issue with our own. To resolve the issues that actually come into your code or into your automation script with your own. So guys, today I'm going to share a few tips with you that actually I do whenever I see any error or exception in the program, or whenever I see something is not working. So what do I do? Few tips that will be helpful for you. So very basic thing is that whenever you will find error next time, do not just care and do not just immediately run towards your friends, colleagues, or your trainer or teacher. Just look at the output console, right? In the output console, you will see certain error in red lines. Might be you are working in Eclipse or in IntelliJ IDEA or some other tools. You will see certain error code there, right? So generally what people think that whenever I'll get such an error, and if I don't know what to do, I'll copy the whole error, put it on the Google, and let's see what happens, or some solution I might get. Okay, probably that's true, probably that might give you the solution. But the better way is, do not copy the whole error. Just find out a statement where the exception is written. Just try to read out this exception line, right? So 90% of your problem you'll understand there itself, right? It says exception in thread main or some exception, right? So try to read that line, and that line will actually help you to identify you the error, right? So resolving the error is not a big deal. Identifying what is the issue is actually a big deal, right? Once you identify the issue, you will find out the ways to resolve it. Problem happens is that you don't understand what is the issue. Okay, so yes, you have read the line of the exception. Next, you will find the line number of your statement from where the exception is being thrown. Most probably it will be in blue line. You click on that blue line, your cursor will be actually reached to the line from where the exception is thrown. Again, this will actually bring you some more knowledge, right? So this is the line from which the exception is thrown. It means that something is weird in this line. Okay, so look at that line, try to guess what could be the wrong things. Okay, and if you still don't understand, then do not copy the whole error message. Just copy the exception line onto the Google and try searching it. Okay, and once you will incorporate this habit within you, so soon you will find certain patterns of the exceptions, right? Some frequent patterns of the exception, those will be frequently there, you'll find that. Okay, few common exceptions I would like to talk about. For example, one very common exception is there, null pointer exception. So null pointer exception is most probably occurred because, let's say, your object is defined but it is not properly initialized. Let's say you have an object driver, so web driver, it is just defined and it is not initialized. Let's say driver is equal to new Chrome driver, or driver is equal to new Firefox driver, it is not written. Okay, sometimes it happens because you have kept it into the method wherein you have forgotten to write @ before class or before method. Most of the time, instead of that, you write @ test. Sometimes you have a JUnit test and your before class is from testng, or your test is testng and your before class is from JUnit. Okay. So these kinds of things may disturb your driver. So this is just one example, but most of the times the null pointer exception comes because of the lack of initialization of object. Okay. So I'm not saying that every time this will be the thing, but most of the times in automation, you'll find null pointer exception because of the object is not being properly initialized. Okay. One more common exception I observe is that no class def found. Okay. Again, if you just copy that error and paste it on the Google, actually its meaning is that some jar or some dependency is actually missing into your libraries. Okay. So your job is to actually find the library or find the jar or find the dependency and add it into your libraries folder, or add that dependency in your form.xml. Another common exception, that no such element exception, or let's say element not interactable exception, right? So this exception most of the times comes because of few reasons. One reason is it could be that the element is in, let's say, some another frame and you're trying to access it from the earlier frame. So in that case, you can switch to that frame and you can get access to that web element. Another way to resolve this issue could be like you can put some weight, like implicit weight, explicit weight, or fluent weight, then it could be resolved. And if it still doesn't resolve, then you can use, let's say, JavaScript executor. Right, JavaScript executor methods we have for clicking the element or for typing into the element, right? So you can use that and get it resolved. These three, I believe, few common exceptions are there. In case if you face any other kind of exception, please put it into the comment. I'll try to generalize it and try to give you the solution as well. So what we learned, whenever you will get an exception, do not just care. Just read out the exception line. Do not copy and paste the whole error into the Google. Just copying the exception line is enough. Copy that and try to get some results and try to understand the answer from the result of the search, right? And whenever you will do it frequently, you will have some practice to resolve the issues with your own. I hope you like this information. Please share this with your friends and colleagues. And if you have still not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe. More such videos. Thank you very much.